So let's solve a system of linear equations by using a method called the Cramers rule. So we have the system of linear equations and we'll convert it into a matrix form like this one here. And this column represents the variable x, the second column represents the variable y, and the third column represents the variable z. So first of all, you'll have to find the determinant of this matrix A. And you'll do that basically by multiplying these three elements of the first row with their respective cofactors. So you'll multiply 2 here with its cofactor. And you'll just to for reminder's sake, how you'll find the cofactors, basically you'll first find the minor of 2 here. So you'll delete the row. You'll delete the column it's in, and you'll delete the row it's in, and then the remaining elements you'll take their determinant, and then you'll multiply minus 1. You'll take the power of minus 1 to the number, row number and the column number of 2 here. So basically the cofactor of this 2 here will be minus 1 raised to the power 1 plus 1, as it is in the first row and first column. And you'll take the determinant of, you'll multiply that with the determinant of minus 2, minus 2, 1 and minus 3. And then you'll multiply the 2 with this cofactor and you'll get this basically. And then you'll add that into the same results for this 2 here and this 1 here, and then you'll get this entire equation. And you can refer back to the lecture where I discussed this earlier to clarify. And so by expanding this, you'll get this equation here. And when you solve this, you get the value of 27. So that is the determinant of A here. Now, you have to find D1, D2, and D3 to find the values of X, Y, and Z. So what are these D1, D2, and D3? Well, you'll see that we've not really put these values, these constants here in the matrix. So what we'll do here is that in D1, you'll put the values, these constants, in place of the column X, and then you'll take its determinant. So 3, 1 and 2 will replace the column X, and the rest will remain the same, and then you'll take its determinant as you did before in the same manner, and then you'll get this 27. That is the value of D1. For D2, what you'll do here is you will replace the Y column with these same constants, and the rest will remain the same, and you'll get the value of 0. So D2 is equal to 0. For D3, you'll replace the Z column with the values of the constants, and you'll take its determinant, and then you'll get the value of 27. So you have D1, D2, and D3 now. Now, what you'll do here, to find the value of X, you'll do D1 divided by the determinant of A. And while you'll do here, how will you know that D1 divided by the determinant of A is X? Because in D1, you replaced the X column with the constants. That is why you'll do X is equal to D1 divided by the determinant of A. So you'll do 27 divided by 27 to get 1. For D2, for Y, you'll do D2 divided by A, because in D2 you replace the column of Y with the constants. And so you'll do 0 divided by 27 to get 0. And similarly for Z, you'll do D3 divided by the determinant of A to get 27 divided by 27 to get Z is equal to 1. So that's the Cramer's rule.